Hello friends, welcome to the Viva, Voce of Anatomy. Today we discuss the thoracic vertebrae. Now we know the thoracic vertebrae are 12 in the number. They are identified by reason of a costal facet. You can see here the costal facet on the side of a body of a vertebrae, which is absent in the cervical as well as lumbar vertebrae. So this is the identification point of the thoracic vertebrae. The costal facet may be one or two in number on the each side. Now out of the 12 thoracic vertebrae, the 2 to 8 thoracic vertebrae are typical, whereas the first 9, 10, 11, 12 are atypical thoracic vertebrae. First we discuss the typical thoracic vertebrae. Okay, but before that you should know about the feature of the typical vertebrae, which is given in the link above. In our previous one of the video, the difference, how to differentiate the cervical, thoracic and the lumbar vertebrae. Now first we discuss the typical vertebrae from the 2nd to 8 in the number. The first, the body. Body is placed anteriorly. It is a heart shape. The measurement of anteroposteriorly and the transverse is nearly equal. Now, unique feature is on the side of the body, there is a two costal demifacet, the superior costal demifacet and inferior costal demifacet. The superior costal demifacet is larger and it articulates with the numerically corresponding same rib, whereas the inferior costal demifacet is smaller and articulates with the next lower rib. So if we consider this vertebrae as a T5, then the superior costal demifacet articulates with the head of a fifth rib and the lower costal demifacet articulates with the sixth rib. Now, other feature of the body of the typical vertebrae is that the body of a T3 is the smallest one and the body of a T4 is a typical heart shape. Now, if we go from above downwards, in the upper thoracic vertebrae, the body is transformed from the cervical to the thoracic vertebrae. Means in the cervical it is broader and in the thoracic it will gradually become the heart shape. And in the lower thoracic vertebrae is transformed from the thoracic to the lumbar. Means from the heart shape to it become gradually larger. This is the body. Now we see the vertebral foramina behind the body. It is a small and circular. Now we see the vertebral arch or neural arch. The first, the pedicle. The pedicle is a short and attached to the upper part of a body, posterior part of the body of the vertebrae. So the superior vertebral node is shallow, but the inferior vertebral node is very deep and conspicuous. Now the lamina. The lamina is a thick, broad and short. The lamina of a typical vertebrae is overlapping each other. So this is a vertebral arch. Now the transverse process. The transverse process is thick, large and it is directed backwards and the laterally. Now the feature in the transverse process is near its tip, it contains the costal facet. This costal facet articulate with the tubercle of a numerically corresponding rib to form the costo-transverse joint. This is a transverse process. Now we see the superior and the inferior articular process. The superior articular process is directed upward from the junction of the pedicle and the lamina. It contains the flat facet, which is directed posterolaterally. This is known as the superior articular facet. Now the inferior articular process. The inferior articular process directed downward from the junction of a pedicle and the lamina. It contains the facet, the flat facet, which is known as the inferior articular facet, which is directed forward and the medial. So this is superior and the inferior articular process. Now the last, the spine. The spine of the typical thoracic vertebrae is a larger, directed backwards and the downwards. Now the spine or the spinous process from the T5 to T8 is largest and lies more obliquely and overlapping each other. So these are the features of a typical thoracic vertebrae. Now we see the attachment. First, the common attachment. The superior and the inferior borders of anterior and the posterior surface provides the attachment of anterior and the posterior longitudinal ligament respectively. The lamina, upper and the lower border, provides the attachment of a ligamentum flava. Now the attachment of the transverse process, its steep provides the attachment of the lateral posterotransverse ligament. Now its anterior surface provides the attachment of inferior posterotransverse ligament. Lower border provides the attachment of superior posterotransverse ligament, and the upper and the lower border provides the attachment of the intertransverse ligament. So these are the attachment of transverse process. Now the spinous process or the spine of the vertebrae. It provides the attachment of a supraspinous and the interspinous ligament. Apart from this common attachment, it also provides the attachment of the important muscle like a trapezius, rhomboidus, latissimus dorsi, serratus posterior superior, serratus posterior inferior, and the sub-deep muscle of a back. So this is all about a typical thoracic vertebrae. Now we see the atypical thoracic vertebrae, that is T1, T9, T10, T11, T12. The first we discuss about the T1. Now first the body. The body is not heart shape, but it is like that of the cervical vertebrae, being broader from the side to side. Now the upper surface of the body is lipped laterally and it is beveled anteriorly. The side of the body contains the superior costal facet, which is full and it articulates with the fossa rib, and the inferior costal facet is a half, it is a dummy facet and articulate with the second rib. The second part, the superior vertebral node, see it is very deep and conspicuous. It is different from the typical thoracic vertebrae in which it was a sun, right? Now the third, the spine is nearly horizontal, long, thick and nearly horizontal. Whereas in the typical, you can see it is a oblique, directed downwards and backwards. Now you may get confused between the T1 and C7 vertebrae. The difference, it look like a same, but the difference is in the C7 vertebrae, in its transverse process, there is a foramina transversarium, whereas in the side of the body, there is an absence of the costal facet. Whereas in the T1, the transverse process is having a no foramina transversarium, and the side of the body is having 1.5 costal facet. So this is about the T1. Now we move to the T9 vertebrae. The T9 vertebrae is like a typical thoracic vertebrae, but only difference is it's having only the upper costal dummy facet, upper costal or a superior costal dummy facet on the side of the body which articulates with the T9. Now the next is the T10. The T10 thoracic vertebrae is like a T9 and the typical thoracic vertebrae, but the only difference is on the side of the body it contains the one single full costal facet for the 10th rib. So this is a T10. Now the T11 is also like a T10, but the difference is the side of the body contains the full single superior costal facet, which is lies in the upper part of a pedicle. Here it lies near the upper border of the body, but here it lies near the pedicle. The second thing in the T11, its transverse process is short and there is an absence of the costal facet in the transverse facet. So that is T11. Next is the T12. The T12, on the side of the body of the T12, also there is a single costal superior facet which is full and lies near the lower part of the pedicle. Next, its shape of a body, pedicle, transverse process and the spinous process is like that of a lumbar vertebrae, right? The transverse process is short and it is marked by a superior, inferior and the lateral tubercle, superior, inferior, lateral tubercle, which is not like a transverse process of a T11. So by that way you can differentiate T11 and the T12. Now below the T12 lies the L1 vertebrae. This is the L1 vertebrae. Now you get confused between the T12 and the L1 because they both look similar. But the difference is here on the side of the body in the lumbar vertebrae, there is an absent of a costal facet. That is only difference. And the transverse process is short. It is not having a tubercle like a T12. The last identification in the T12 is the inferior articular facet is everted. It is more facing laterally. Whereas you can see in the T11, it is facing anteriorly. This facet is facing anteriorly. So this is all about a thoracic vertebrae. Thank you.
If you like our video, click on the like button and share with your friends. To get the regular updates on anatomy video by Viva Voce of Anatomy, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.